Hello friends, how are you? Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to talk about another very important topic, that is blood group physiology. After this lecture, you will be able to understand ABO blood group system and RH blood group system effectively. You will be able to understand the role of different antigens in determining the blood group. How some of the individual will be having A group, some of the individual will be having A positive group, and some other types of groups as well. So let's start the topic. To understand the blood group system effectively, first of all, you must know what is antigen. Antigen is any substance that can stimulate your immune system. It means any substance against which your immune system, your B cells, will start making antibodies are called as antigen. This is a structure of antibody. So any substance against which your body will start making antibodies will be called as antigen. Clear? Okay. Now, on the RBC, red blood cells, different types of antigens are present, which determine the specific type of blood group. To understand about the type of blood group and the role of antigen, first of all, let me give you a brief introduction of all types of antigens. There are basically four major types of antigens present on our red blood cell. The one is H antigen, second one is A antigen, then B antigen, then RH antigen or D antigen. I will talk about more about this antigen in later part of the video. So first of all, let me tell you what is H antigen. H antigen is present on all type of blood group. Either it is A, it is B, it is A positive, it is A negative, all type of blood group must be having this H antigen. Now, what is this H antigen? This is basically a polysaccharide chain. Here you can see this H antigen is made up of polysaccharide chain. Attached with a sugar called as fructose. Just like lactose and mannose, another type of sugar called as fructose is attached with this polysaccharide chain. Okay, now this collectively it will be called as H antigen. Clear? Now, what is A antigen? In the A antigen, along with the H antigen, another sugar moiety, N-acetyl galactosamine, NAGA, another sugar will be attached or will be present over this polysaccharide. Now, this complex of sugars will be called as A antigen. Okay, this is H antigen, and if another sugar called as NAGA or N-acetyl galactosamine will be present on the H antigen, it will be now called as A antigen. Similarly, instead of NAGA, if we place galactose on this H antigen, this is polysaccharide chain, this is fructose sugar, collectively it will be called as H antigen. But if we place galactose over this polysaccharide chain, now this antigen will not be called as A antigen, now it will be called as B antigen. If NAGA will be present over there, it will be called as A antigen. If galactose will be present over there, it will be called as B antigen. H antigen, A antigen, and B antigen. Clear? Okay. Now, there is another type of antigen. And all these antigens are basically related to ABO blood group system. ABO blood group system. Okay. And this RH antigen or RH factor is related to RH blood group system. RH blood group system. So this H antigen is basically a protein in nature. All these antigens are carbohydrate in nature. While this RH antigen is a protein in nature. If it is a protein in nature, you know, protein is made up of amino acids, and it must be having carboxylic acid and a meanet or a minet. Okay, now this RH antigen is a 7-pass membrane protein. It means it will pass 12-pass. It's not 7-pass, 12-pass. 12-pass membrane protein. It means it will completely pass through the cell membrane of red blood cell by 12 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay? And a 1 at outside, this chain, that is a part of this protein. This blue color chain is also a part of this protein. It will be called as D antigen. D antigen. This RH protein have almost 50 different types, but we will only talk about D antigen, because most prominently this RH or D antigen is present on our blood cells. Okay, so we will only talk about this antigen. Now this was the introduction of antigen. Okay, okay, now here you can see I have explained that H antigen is present on all types of blood group. For example, this is a red blood cells. We don't know the blood group of individual is A or B or O or whatever, but we know that whatever will be the blood group, H antigen must be present. This H antigen, it must be present in all type of the blood group. Okay, if the patient or individual have blood group A, if a patient or individual have blood group A, we know that on the A antigen, a Naga protein will be present over this oligosaccharide. Now point is how this Naga protein will be transferred. The patient or individual having A blood group, they must be having nucleus, they must be having chromosome. On the chromosome number 9, a specific gene will be present. A specific gene will be present. Now once this gene will be transcribed, what is transcription? Conversion of DNA into RNA. Inside this chromosome, DNA will be present. Now once this gene will be transcribed, RNA will be formed. This RNA will come out of the nucleus. It will attach on the ribosome. And a protein will be formed. This protein will be formed. The name of this protein is N-acetyl galactosamine transferase, or we can say Naga transferase. Again, I will say the blood patient or individual having blood group A, they must be having a nucleus. On the chromosome number 9, a gene will be present. When this gene will express after the process of transcription and translation, protein will be formed, and this protein will be called as Naga transferase protein. Now this protein is basically responsible for transporting the Naga molecules. Obviously, N-acetylglucosamine will be present in the cytoplasm of the red blood cell. This enzyme will help in the transportation of this Naga over the H antigen. And when Naga will be attached with this H antigen, now this antigen will be called as A antigen, and all the individual who express A antigen on their red blood cell, they will be having A blood group. Forget about the A negative and A positive. We will talk about A negative and A positive in later part of the video. Right now, just focus that this individual will be having A blood group because it is having A antigen. Okay. Now, another point is how we know that the nucleus is not present in RBCs. The mature RBCs do not have nucleus. then how can we say that it will be having chromosome number 9 and a gene will be expressed and Naga will be transported? Point is, when this RBC was immature, when it was erythroblast, at that time nucleus was present. So at that time the expression of these genes will taken place and this enzyme will be formed, which will be responsible for transporting Naga over the H antigen, and the individual's blood group will be called as A blood group. Okay, after the maturation, when the RBC will get mature, this nucleus will be removed. So it means the determination of blood group have been done when it was erythroblast. Clear? Okay. Similarly, if the patient blood group is B, again, if the individual blood group is B, again on the chromosome number 9, at the same locus, the gene that will be present, it will get transcribed, RNA will be formed. This RNA will come out of the nucleus, it will attach on the ribosomes, and protein will be formed. Okay, protein will be formed. If a person have blood group B, I am talking about, a protein will be formed. But this time, the protein that is being formed, it is not Naga transferase. This protein will be galactose transferase. If this enzyme is galactose transferase, obviously this enzyme will transfer galactose protein. Galactose from the cytoplasm. This enzyme will transfer galactose sugar over the H antigen. Now, this, when the galactose sugar is present over the H antigen, that antigen will be called as B antigen, and the blood group of the patient will be B group. It will not be A now, because the antigen is B. Okay, so the difference is, in A blood group, the Naga transferase enzyme will be formed. In B blood group, galactose transferase enzyme will be formed, and these enzymes are responsible for transporting different type of sugar. So obviously blood group will be different. Again, point is, H antigen must be present. If a patient have both, for example, here is a nucleus, and we know that each chromosome is present in pairs, one from the paternal and one from the maternal. If one chromosome produce Naga transferase and the other chromosome produce galactose transferase, it means both type of the sugars will be transported. The enzyme Naga transferase will transport Naga sugar, and the enzyme galactose transferase will cause the transportation of galactose over the H protein. Now, this type of RBC having both the antigen, it is having A antigen, it is having B antigen. So this type of individual will be having AB blood group, because its RBC, its red blood cell, have both type of antigen present on the surface of the red blood cell. So if both of the genes do not express, I will talk about in next video, I will talk about the genetics, genotype of this RBC. Right now I am talking about the phenotypes. So how the expression will be taken place, I will talk about these things in later next video. Okay, so point is, if no enzyme is formed, if no gene express neither for the Naga transferase and neither for the galactose transferase, it mean that H antigen are present, but neither galactose will be transported, neither the NAGA will be transported on the H antigen. Only H antigen is present, and this type of blood group will be called as O antigen, because O antigen, because A antigen is not present, B antigen is not present, only H antigen present. So the blood group will be called as O blood group. Okay, now let's talk about the antibodies. Antibodies. What are antibodies? Against the antigen, our body produces antibodies. So obviously, if the individual is having A blood group, okay, its body cannot produce A antibody, because this antibody is its own antibody, or this antigen is its own antigen, and antibodies are not produced against own antigen, otherwise immunogenic reaction will start. Okay, so this person can never have A antibody or anti-A antibody, because if this person will be having A antibodies, these antibodies will come, they will attach over these RBCs, and agglutination will occur. Agglutination of RBCs will occur. The reaction between RBC and antibody will occur. So this person will never be having A antibody, but this person will be having anti-B antibody. This from where these antibodies are coming? Obviously, the immune system of this person is producing these anti-B antibody because of environmental stimulation. Because of environmental factor, the B antigen was transported into his body, and against that B antigen, the B antibodies were produced. Again, I will say, if the patient is having A antigen, it can never have A antibody, because otherwise antigen antibody reaction will taken place, but it can have B antibody. Okay, similarly, if a patient or individual is having B blood group or B antigen, it can never have B antibody, but it must be having A antibody, anti-A antibody. It will be having anti-A antibody because it does not have A antigen on its own. Similarly, so a individual with blood group A have A antigen and anti-B antibody. Individual with blood group B will be having B antigen and anti-A antibody. A patient having AB blood group, so it cannot produce A antibody or B antibody, because if it produces A antibody or B antibody, the reaction between antigen and antibody will be taken place, and agglutination of RBC will occur. So this patient will not have anti-A antibody, it will not have anti-B antibody. Clear? And if you talk about the O blood group, it does not have any antigen. So this blood group or this individual will be having anti-A antibody and anti-B antibody. Anti-A antibody and anti-B antibody, because no antigen is present, so no reaction will be taken place, so antibodies will be present. Clear? Now let's talk about Rh antibodies. Rh antibody. Rh antibody are protein in nature. The genes for these antibodies are present in chromosome number 1. So if this gene expresses and Rh or D antibody Rh antigen is formed, the presence of Rh or D antigen indicate that blood group will be positive. Now let's come back. For example, this patient have A antigen, so it means its blood group is A, but if it also have another antibody, that is D antigen, It also have another antigen, D antigen. Now this patient is having A antigen and D antigen. This individual will be having A positive blood group. But if this individual only have A antigen but it does not have D antigen, the individual will be having A negative blood group. If this have A antigen but do not have H antigen or D antigen, Rh antigen, D antigen, it will be called as A negative. If it has both A antigen and Rh or D antigen, it will be having A positive. Similarly, if individual have B antigen but it does not have any Rh antigen or D antigen, it will be called as B negative because it is not having D antigen. But if it have B antigen and also have D antigen, it also have B antigen, it have D antigen, now the blood group will be B positive. Okay, similarly, if a patient have AB both antigen but it does not have D antigen, it will be AB negative. But if it have A antigen, B antigen and D antigen, AB, A antigen, B antigen and D antigen, now this patient will be called as this will be having AB positive blood group because D antigen or Rh antigen is also present over there. See, okay. Now in this it does not have any antigen. If it also do not have Rh antigen or D antigen, it will be having O negative blood group. But if it does not have A antigen, it does not have B antigen, but it have D antigen, it will be called as O positive blood group. O positive blood group. And if you talk about the anti-D antibody, obviously if antigen is present, anti-D antibody will not be present. For example, in O positive, Rh is present. So, anti-D antibody will not be present. Similarly, if Rh antigen is present or D antigen is present, D antibody will not be present. For example, in B negative blood group, this antigen is present, B antigen is present, but D antigen is not present. If D antigen is not present, it means in his blood anti-D antibody will be present. But in B positive group, B antigen is present and D antigen is present. Both antigens are present. So it means neither it will be having anti-B antibodies, but it will not be having anti-D antibodies as well because antigen is present. If it will produce anti-D antibody, this antibody will react with this antigen and agglutination will occur. So if antigens are present on the RBC, against that antigen, antibodies should not be present in the blood group. Otherwise, immunogenic reaction will take place and agglutination of RBCs will take place. This thing will be further explained when I will explain the transfusion physiology. How blood groups are transfused or matching of blood group system. Okay, I hope you like this video. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon and like this video as well. Press the bell so that you may get notification for the future videos. Thank you so much.